Togito, Mago, Fudo, Kazunoko, and Bonchan.
And you know what? I don't think Fudo has played yet. I don't think Fudo has played yet at all. And here comes Tokido on the stage. You see him followed immediately by Razor, Fudo, Mad Cats, Mago, Kazunoko, and Bonchan. Kazunoko, Tokido, Fudo, Mago, Kazunoko, Bonchan. Alright, Team Korea has come up onto stage. We have Infiltration, Narex, Laugh, Kim Legend, and Street 11.
Oh, these guys are gonna do the Whoa Korea!
Yep. There you go. They wanna take this over Team Japan. And now Bonchan is saying, let's do the same thing. He's like, gather, gather, gather. Come on, guys, let's gather. There we go. Look at them. They are
Team
huddled
Japan.
Up.
Team Japan prayer.
Getting into a scrum there. There you go.
All right. We are ready for some Street Fighter 4. This is what it's all come down to,
Arcade
James
Edition
Shen.
2012, 5v5 here at Canada Cup 2012.
It's been a long weekend. You know, Team Japan is the reigning Canada Cup 5-on-5 champions. We'll see if they can hold their own and keep it going 2 years in a row.
Yep, they want to keep it
Team
this
Korea.
Way. And I do believe Bonchan, I'm sorry, Kazunoko is the only one who was actually on the team last year.
Right.
Yeah,
yes.
Kazunoko. And Tokido, Mago.
They were on the other Japanese
right,
team.
They're
on Japan 1.
Right. They were the ones who got who were defeated by
Yeah, they got like third.
USA team
yeah.
with Wolf Crone.
This year, I mean, the I don't know. The Americans kind of they were split, you know, amongst
right.
two different teams.
Well, they yeah.
Hard to say what would have happened if there would have only been one American
right.
team.
Which is always hard because two of our best players are Ricky and Justin, and every time they're on the same team, they can't use the same character.
Right.
They're both Rufus players.
Right.
Justin obviously has a lot of secondary characters, but Rufus is always his best.
Yeah.
No matter what.
But yeah, I mean, let's give everybody a quick recap as to how we got to this point. Japan OCV'd Canada 1, and then USA 1 defeated the Netherlands team. Then USA 2 beat Team Korea.
That's right, with PR Rog's amazing...
Four players in a row. Yeah.
Comeback.
And then Canada 2 lost to Southeast Asia.
Also an OCV.
Also an OCV, ending with a double perfect by Kaiser against...
White Gun.
White Gun, yes, the Ibuki player. And then in the loser's bracket, Team Canada 1 eliminated the Netherlands team. And then Korea eliminated Canada 2. And then today... that was also today. Today, Japan beat USA 1. USA 2 beat Team Southeast Asia. Southeast Asia then lost. I mean, then defeated Canada 1. And then lost to Korea.
And Korea defeated USA 1. And then also defeated USA 2 after defeating Southeast Asia. And that brings us here to Korea versus Japan. This is the grand finals. Again, Korea coming from loser's bracket, needing to win two sets over Japan.
Hey, Kev, can you put that headset off before
the shot? Awesome.
They are starting with Narex versus Mago. Mago going first every single time for Team Japan. Here we go. Let's see what Narex can do.
Yeah, Mago unfortunately can't be playing. Couldn't play Feilong or his secondary character Sagat because his two teammates are using those characters.
Yep, and if you also remember, Gamerbee defeated Mago. He lost the first round. I mean, defeated Narex. He lost the first round and then won the next two. The last one with a perfect. So let's see if Mago can do as well as Gamerbee. Right now, he's looking good. Chasing him down with a couple of Tiger Knee Jaguar kicks and then a throw.
Oh, big opportunity to punish right there.
It was just happened to be in the middle of a backdash, unfortunately. All right, trying to get himself in. And look at this. Narex just sitting back there, almost as if he's building meter. But he's down in life, so he's got to get at Mago. He's got to figure out a way to do some damage really quickly.
Yeah, he's got a lot of time, though. Still 40 seconds left on the
clock. Oh, wow.
Mago was just waiting for that.
The whole time he was waiting for that. Oh, he's got it. Boom. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Let's see what he follows up with.
Nice stuff. Oh, wow. Oh, no. Just went under and he couldn't kick in the back.
Could have done the Thunder Knuckle. That would have killed him. Uh-oh.
Oh, and an air-to-air meetup. An infiltration is hyped for Narex taking that round. All right, like I said, Narex took the first round against Gamerbee as well. Then Gamerbee took the next two rounds. But Gamerbee, obviously, his main character is Aidon, whereas Mago, this is his secondary or tertiary character.
Mago working on a full super meter right here. It's going to give him two opportunities to uppercut FADC to get out of trouble if it comes to that. Both players playing very safe. You know, this is the very first set. No need to do anything too crazy.
Wow, EX uppercut. That was unusual. And then just hit him from the front. Not sure if that was an unblockable. And baits it out.
No, didn't FADC. Well, it's not the meter right there anyways.
Oh, uh-oh. Nice. That looked like an empty jump into a low attack or such.
Yeah, Narex with the throw.
And then he did a air Jaguar kick in the sky, throwing off Narex's timing, and Narex got caught.
Oh, wow. EX uppercut to get out of trouble. Both players playing extremely patient, very safe. Korea, actually, you know, they had to play it a little bit safer. You know, Team Japan has one set to give. They can afford to take more risks.
But still, at the same time, if you lose that first set, you've given your opponents a lot of momentum.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Mago playing a little more solid, still down in life. So he still has to figure out a way to get into Narex right now. There it is, but just a little too far. Should have just went for the sweep instead of low strong. Got him. Oh, wow. Air Jaguar kicking right over that Seismo. Good block, but here comes Narex. Gets the life lead back.
Both players just about even on life. Uh-oh.
Not anymore. Oh, chase down, and he lost a lot of life because he had just Focus Absorb to move. So he lost basically twice the amount of damage. We're getting hit by that. Oh, look at that.
Wow.
Trying to get in there and throw in a frame trap. Narex with a frame trap. Defeating Mago.
Team Korea, that may have been Narex's first win of the day.
I think so,
but this was the one that counted, James Chen.
Exactly. But unfortunately, all you do is just bring in Bonchan or Tokido or Fudo or Kaznoko, and here comes Bonchan. And Narex feeling very happy. You can tell he's very pleased.
That's right. Laugh giving his teammate some talking advice, to about strategy. I don't see Narex texting his girlfriend or anything, so they may be sharing notes at this point.
Yep, just probably some tendencies or some strategies. Mm-hmm. I mean, I don't know how well Laugh or Infiltration know Viper.
Yeah, I don't know either.
All right, here they go.
But they have played Bonchan many times, I'm sure.
So Bonchan, of course, going with Sagat. Going with Ultra One against the Sea Viper. And Narex right now still discussing with Laugh some strategies.
Yeah.
Has not quite yet finished picking his character.
Infiltration, patting his teammate on the back, trying to calm him down. You can tell that Narex is nervous because both Infiltration and Laugh are both doing their best to calm him down.
Yeah.
Narex knows, and he may not be used to the pressure.
No.
Bonchan has been, you know, he's one of the best players, in Japan. He's, played in many high-pressure situations at EVO, God's Garden, all around the world.
Is that a banana on the table?
Yes, that was Narex's banana. He was just eating that.
Nice, okay. Get a little bit of
healthy
energy power in there.
Yep. Yeah, man. Get exactly. That potassium.
Exactly.
Fuel your brain. That's not true. I don't know.
Fill your brain.
Fuel your brain. With the potassium. I don't know if that's true. Don't listen to me.
Someone should make him like a dragon kale mix or
hey,
shake
man.
Or something like that.
Works for me. Except for this weekend. I'm hella fat.
I'm right there with you. Just been eating junk. Well, then again, I've been that even before this weekend. So
options
whatever.
Are it's limited, like man. I got to get back home ASAP before I just blow up. Anyways, back to the training stage. The match is about to start. Bonchan and Narex. A friendly handshake. Nothing but respect here between these two players. I think Bonchan definitely has the edge, though.
Understood.
In terms of experience in high-pressure situations.
For sure.
Who will emerge a champion? Fight!
All right, match started. Oh, tried to counter air-to-air with a jump fierce, but Narex did a short burn kick, so dropped straight down. Trying to bait Bonchan into trying to counter. Saw the whiff low roundhouse into the whiff thunder knuckle. Faking Seismos all day.
Uh-oh. These guys played earlier, didn't they?
I can't remember now. Did they play
I
in the singles?
Like no, like in teams.
I don't think so, because these two teams haven't played each other.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you're right. Okay.
Ow! Standing roundhouse to the head.
Narex, not a strong first round. Barely able to do any damage or build any meter.
Tokido pumping up Bonchan and murder facing it up right now. Look at that look. Look at that stare from Tokido.
Oh no, missed an opportunity to anti-air with the Thunder Knuckle. Ouch.
Ooh,
missed uppercut.
Yeah, it was definitely supposed to be an uppercut.
Oh. Alright. Now Narex has got a little momentum going. Nope. Not more. Ow.
Nice! That combo does so much damage and it connects from so far away too, which is one of the things that makes it so good. It's like if you tag him with low forward, you're almost always guaranteed to get that whole thing.
This could be it for Narex, right? Yep, that Bonchan ends it.
With the Kara Tiger Knee. Catches Narex off guard. Let's see who they send in to fight against a Sagat.
Is it gonna be Laugh? Oh, they're gonna send Street 11? Yeah. Or they're gonna send Kim?
It's hard to say right now.
Well, let's. I don't know, man. It's a tough call, you know? How do you feel like Blanca does against Sagat?
Blanca against Sagat? I feel like Blanca can fight him pretty decently. Might be one of Blanca's better chances in this whole situation. I mean, he's going to do well against Akuma as well, so they might want to save him for Tokido. So it looks like Laugh is coming up. Going to be Ryu versus
Sagat.
There
we go. I like that. I like that play. Ryu Sagat, even match. Laugh can definitely, pull this one off. I don't know that it makes sense to send Gen or Blanca up against Sagat right there. So it looks like Laugh is going to have to hold it down.
Classic matchup, Ryu versus Sagat.
Yep, we're going to look through the notes. Earlier, you know, Laugh had a really clutch win against Alex Valle. So Laugh is doing pretty well for himself today.
Yep, you saw there, Ryan was testing out all of the buttons. One of the buttons didn't do anything when he hit it. Map to the back button so that they can plink. So people don't understand, plinking, you know, you hit two buttons in a row and there's that priority, right? So if you want to plink a strong button, you plink it to jab or short. If you want to plink a roundhouse button, you can plink it to any of the other five buttons. However, there is actually an extra button that counts and has the weakest priority of them all, and that is back on the Xbox 360 or select on the PlayStation. So technically, any button can be plinked into that. Now, normally, the biggest problem is you can't plink a jab because there is no button of lower priority than it. By allowing yourself the select button at a readily usable location, you can actually plink to it.
So you're saying to open up your stick, take out the switch for the select button or the back button,
mm-hmm.
and plug that into, let's say, all three punch or all three kicks.
Right.
And then map all three punches.
You don't even have to map it. Yeah, because it's already mapped to select or back. Well, what this allows you to do.
So let's say that you're using a TE, right?
Mm-hmm.
Here, I got one right here.
Okay.
Now,
so the Canada
are
Cup
you
TE.
Saying that they are using this to plink or this one of these
that
to plink?
That to plink. So they'll do this.
Ah, okay, gotcha.
Jab into that button there.
Gotcha.
Okay. There's a couple of videos of Sako playing, demonstrating the Fighting Edge stick from Hori with some Kami combos. And watch when Kami does drill FADC dash forward into low jab. Low jab is the only button that you can really combo from that point to extend it. Watch Sako's hands. He plinks with one of those other buttons on his pinky. You can see him do it. They've remapped it. And so the reason why that's so valuable is because when you block Balrog's dash punch, you're -3. So a 3-frame jab can punish it, and most of the 3-frame jabs can be linked afterwards. You can do a longer combo.
But you can only do it, you only have one frame to do it.
Perfectly, exactly. Unless you plink with the bat button, now you have 2 frames to do it. So you've turned it into a 2-frame punish. And that's what mapping that button allows you to do.
That's pretty crazy, James Chen. I gotta tell you, I don't know how I feel about that. I don't know how I should feel about that.
Yeah, they need to patch that out. They just need to patch it so that the back and the select button aren't actually something that's considered an input.
Whoa!
Great chase down left. Oh wow! And then Bonchan says, "You know what? I'm just gonna DP."
What if Ryu would have uppercut it at the same time? What would have happened?
If Ryu could have timed it so that he did it just like 1 or 2 frames after Sagat did it, he would have won.
The character that uppercuts last is the one that has priority.
If they have about the same amount of invincibility frames. If it's like an EX versus a regular, then it's never going to matter, right? The EX is going to win.
Oh no, Laugh is messing up his... That's the second time that Laugh has messed up his safe jump in this match right now.
And now Laugh is just going fireball crazy, which is fine by Bonchan because Bonchan's winning. So he'll just sit here and throw tigers all day.
Yeah, Laugh has definitely got some work to do.
And look at Bonchan building up some ultra. He focused a couple of fireballs. Now he has the ultra. So Laugh is a little more scared to throw fireballs all of a sudden.
That's right. If you guys saw Bonchan versus Infiltration yesterday, they were both going for the dash up ultra fireball because you can see it on the action if you're waiting for it.
Oh, there's that combo again.
Oh my
god. Just catches him off guard. that's it.
Oh, my gosh.
Bon Chan takes it, so let's see who they send up next. I think they're going to send up Street 11.
Oh, my gosh.
Canadian crew here cheering for him.
Yes, Street 11, a Canadian-born Korean. Selected, I believe, at the last moment to replace Punko.
That is correct.
This is not looking good for Team Korea, I gotta say.
Now remember, Team Japan only needs to win this one set
right,
for them to claim victory.
Yeah, Korea is coming out of loser's bracket, so they have to win two sets. And I don't know, man. So Japan is up. Three to one.
Japan is up currently.
2-1.
I think 2-1. Yeah, 2-1.
Yeah.
This is the third player on Team Korea, and Canada here. All the Canadian players cheering for Street 11.
Hometown hero.
Who will emerge a champion? Fight! Gonna be a tough road. I mean, I do think Gen works pretty decently against Sagat, but not against Bon Chan. Bon Chan is such a frightening Sagat.
Yeah.
Never left playing him even after he got nerfed from Vanilla to Super. Just been playing Sagat the whole time. And I do believe Sagat still a very strong character in this game. Yeah, he's no Vanilla Sagat, but then again, very few of the characters are.
Oh my gosh. This is not looking good for Team Korea. Street 11 has got to be playing to win. You know, he's playing like he's...
Oh, jeez. All right, he's got in. Oh right, no, misses the waterfall kick. Or lightning legs, depending on which one he makes. And then he just walks into a jump attack. Bon Chan going in there. Uppercut FADC throw. Sagat is minus one, I think, on that. Minus one or minus two. So he shouldn't be able to beat other things with the throw if you attack with a three-frame move. Or if you try to throw first. And then I think he just wanted to chip him. And Street 11 taken down quickly. Who are they going to send up next? They're going to send up Kim Legend, it looks like. No.
Nope.
Wow.
Nope. Did you see that? I don't know if you guys at home saw that. But Kim Legend got up and Infiltration just pushed his stick down and said, allow me.
Infiltration says, no.
No.
I got this.
Yep. Everybody chill out. I got this.
I'm going to take this.
All right, well, I gotta say, James Chen, if Infiltration doesn't win this, I think it's over.
Most likely, yeah, but it's even if Infiltration wins this, it's still a long road ahead of him. He's got three extremely tough opponents. Kazunoko with that amazing Yun. Always been using him since AE. Dabbled in Seth a little bit, but mostly stuck with Yun. Loves the rushdown capabilities that he has. If it's not him, then it's Tokido with the scientific Akuma. One of the most scientific Akumas in the business.
And if it's not him, then it'll be none other than Fudo, 2011 Street Fighter 4 Evo champion.
Just won this small little tournament called Evolution 2011.
No big deal, you know.
Just people from all over the world. Yeah. One of the largest fighting game tournaments ever, only to be outdone by Evolution 2012.
That's right. And Fudo, as you mentioned earlier, hasn't even played yet.
Yeah, if Fudo can make it through this whole thing without even touching the joystick, it'll be pretty...
What?
Pretty impressive for him. He'll just be like, yeah!
Free money.
Exactly.
All day. All right, well, this is what it's all come down to. Infiltration versus Bonchan. One game.
Excuse me, sir. Sorry.
Let's say Infiltration wins. Who do they put up next?
Tokido.
For the mirror match?
I think so, yeah. Because Tokido has the ability to defeat Infiltration, but you're still leaving Fudo and Kazunoko at the end. But you know what? I bet you if this happens, they are going to go to Kazunoko. I have the funny feeling if Infiltration wins, they'll probably go to Kazunoko. Save Tokido and Fudo for last. Boom. Boom, 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 boom.
All right, it looks like we are almost ready to go. Once Infiltration finishes texting his new Hungarian supermodel girlfriend.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, today's category is Street Fighter characters. Here is your final Jeopardy answer. This character bears a scar on his chest after
who
being defeated by the... Congratulations, how much did you wager? All of it.
All of it.
All of it.
All right, here we go.
It's the battle of the century. Fight! Tiger Shark!
All right, Infiltration carrying the weight of Korea on his shoulders. Nothing new for this man. Ooh, there
nice,
we go.
Nice, baited that out. And he's nice. Gotten the empty jump in the throw on Bonchan. Oh no, mistimed his safe jump. Got uppercutted by Bonchan. Here we go. Now the helpful, oh he got
no.
The crumple, he got it. See, the helpful
no.
thing in this match here is that Tokido has probably played Bonchan a lot, so Tokido probably able to tell him when he is has a safe jump and when he's likely not to be going for the safe jump. One of the best ways to defeat.
Oh no.
One of the best ways to defeat the Akuma Vortex is to know which options he has. The problem is a lot of people don't study him enough, including myself. And off of certain knockdowns, he gets certain setups. And if you can know which setups he's capable of and narrow it down to those, you don't have to guess like 17 different options, but just the two or three that he actually has. Oh, he's going for unblockable or something, but Bonchan must have mistimed it because Bonchan successfully blocked it. Okay, punishes that whiff stand roundhouse.
Infiltration still got a solid lead though. Walking his way out of the corner.
Oh, what a great
hurts.
Punish. Oh, and then he just gets up with the uppercut. Be careful!
Oh,
I was about to say
God.
The cross-up forward kick not causing a lot of block stun. So that uppercut was, you knew that it had to been coming.
Yeah, plus, you know, Bonchan wanted to reply with an uppercut of his own. An unsafe uppercut of his own.
Oh, all hit right. him out of the air. I expect an EX Tiger shot just to push him back. Wow, Infiltration back mostly all the way out himself. And I love that. Bonchan just blocked that fireball. Too many times people try to avoid fireballs, and that one time he blocked it, and it kind of threw Infiltration off. Oh, great sweep, and here we go.
Oh,
huge
wow, he got it. He got it.
Not
quite enough, though.
Dead yet. Oh!
Made him uppercut. But, hey, you know, they have an entire Japanese team to go through as well as another set if they did lose.
And Bonchan is still in it though. He can still take this round.
Yeah, Bonchan definitely more apt to take risks in this situation since his team has a lot more going for it. Being able to give the extra set.
All right, Bonchan with a ever so slight lead. Already 1/4 of the round through. Alright, just shooting him out of the air. Try the dive kick. Teleport back. Interesting. Oh, great distancing on that Tiger Knee to make sure it hits twice like that.
Whoa! Oh,
shenanigans. Sagat shenanigans. Look at this. Bonchan just running a clinic right now. This round. Oh, he's only lost a tiny bit of his life. Infiltration needs to get a really good vortex sequence going. Here it goes. Blocked. Bonchan has escaped, and Bonchan has defeated Infiltration. And only one hope left, and that is Kim Legend. He is the last player left who can keep this going. And it's got to be disheartening to Kim Legend that the Japanese team is practically celebrating like they've won already, because they know they have four guys to go up against the Blanka, and Blanka not one of the stronger characters in this game. And if Bonchan can take this, we may conclude this team tournament without Fudo ever pressing a single button during this tournament. If I'm not mistaken, he might have played, but I don't remember Fudo ever playing, because I don't ever remember seeing him bust out Fei Long.
Man. Tiger knee in the corner, get to the other side, and then just uppercut FADC.
That almost sounds like a fairy tale poem right there. Tiger knee, get to the other side, uppercut FADC.
You are a poet.
And I did not know it. Oh, man.
Man, I can't believe it. I can't believe that just happened.
Bonchan, very solid, showing that Sagat still a force to be reckoned with. And now it is just down to Blanka versus Sagat.
The what? I'm here on my own free will.
Kim Legend, if he can defeat the rest of Team Japan, he will truly be a legend in Korea. Let's see what he can do.
Okay, one thing at a time. Just beat Bonchan.
Kim Legend trying to do the Kim Possible. See if he can defeat the rest of the entire Japanese team.
Whoa!
Nice throw. I mean, this fight isn't horrible for Blanka, because he's got those EX Blanka balls to make it through the Tiger shots, but again,
he's got a lot of mobility.
We saw Vi, you know, in a bad matchup as well, take out Blanka pretty easily. And I'm sure Bonchan knows this fight just as well. Oh no, he missed an uppercut, giving Kim Legend an opportunity. Oh, so much damage. Oh, wow. And then he gets the ultra. And now down one round, this really has become the Kim Probable. Let's see if he can do this. It's just too much work to defeat this many players. Bonchan's defense right now is impenetrable. All right, getting in there, just trying to do as much chip as possible. But Bonchan just not giving an inch, not giving a single centimeter.
Yeah, Kim Legend.
Good block. Okay, good stuff.
There we go.
Kim Legend.
A small, tiny lead now.
Oh, okay. Good stuff. Gets the throw. Forward throw. What kind of mix-up does he have? What setup does he have?
No setup. The setup was no setup.
He was trying to bait an uppercut, but then once they don't uppercut, you got to have something. Kara uppercut, then activates Angry Scar. Now Kim Legend going with Ultra 2, so none of the crazy shenanigans. Be careful of that uppercut. I think that's like a 220 damage uppercut.
Oh, there it was,
and it misses. And he loses his Angry Scar, so he can charge up again. And electricity from the friend. He's just going to try to chip him down. And it worked. So he did it early enough so that the first one whiffed early so that there wasn't really much time. So that's really smart stuff.
That's pretty crazy. I haven't seen it used like that.
Yeah. Very interesting. Very interesting. I think the correct way to counter that is if you can forward jump, I don't think that the ultra is hitting meaty, so the first one's gonna miss, so I think you could probably dash forward and then jump and try to avoid the second one that way. But it might last too long, not sure, I'll have to test it out. But Bonchan with a huge lead now. But here we go, three hits. If he can get another sequence, okay. Mate, one more good sequence, he can knock him dizzy, but okay, never mind.
Off.
Yeah, he backed off.
He had a lot of momentum going, but now he's given Bonchan an opportunity to recompose himself.
Oh, I think he tried to ultra there.
No.
Oh, and
no.
That's going to be it. Team Japan has won 2 years in a row for the 5v5 international event. Japan, 2 years in a row, undefeated. Kazunoko, Bonchan, Tokido, Mago, and some other dude who just sat there and watched, AKA Fudo. Congratulations to Team Japan. Great job to them taking this tournament. They are your 2012 International 5v5 champions. And again, we have, they're giving away an awesome Canada Cup stick. Congratulations for Team Korea getting knocked to loser's bracket first round and then working all the way, getting all the way back up to grand finals, but then Team Japan just too strong.